Oh. talking. And I'm pretty sure they're from Happy Valley area schools. And one of them was talking about a conversation that she overheard in the cafeteria. And these three girls, there's three girls talking. And the first, and her name was Susan. And she says, "You know, my daddy scribbles down words on paper. He calls it a poem. And they pay him $50 for it." But you know how little girls like to brag. And the second one, her name is Brittany. And she says, "Well, my daddy scribbles down words on paper. He calls it a song. They pay $200 to him." And the third little girl, her name was Ashley. And that's just Mr. Angle. And she said, "You know, my daddy scribbles down words on paper too. He calls it a sermon." And she said, "I don't know how much they pay him, but it takes 4 minutes for a must tell Jesus, Jesus can help me, Jesus alone.
Yeah.
I must tell Jesus all of my trials. I cannot bear these burdens alone. In my distress, your kindly will help me. He even loves and cares for his own. He ever loves and cares for his own. They sung that song about, I don't know if anybody is on this song, first time I heard that song that I can remember. And it's, I don't think anyone could have sung it, anybody could sing it any better. But I thought I need the words of that song. And I got some songbooks at the house. And the first book I picked up, it was on the second page. And that was a confirmation to what I'm saying. But Amy, after they sung the song, Amy stood up and testified that she went 3 weeks waiting on some tests she had done. Praise the Lord, they all come back negative. But she had only told a couple of people. She didn't want to worry her family and friends and with that word. But she did have someone else to tell. And we have someone we can talk to. Jesus. When we have our spouses, we can tell them. We have some best friends. Sometimes we tell our best friends what we can't tell our spouses. Sometimes we tell a total stranger things we cannot tell anybody else. Sometimes we can talk to the preacher, but sometimes we don't have anywhere to turn except to Jesus. And he wants to know all about us. He already knows our thoughts. But he wants to express to him our thoughts and our burdens. And he wants to listen because he cares and he loves for us. And if you don't know Jesus today, if he's not your best friend, if you cannot talk to him, you need to turn your heart over to him today. And because no matter what's going on in our lives, no matter what burdens, what troubles we have, Jesus is a close friend, and he's always with us. He'll never leave us as we can have. As the four men come forward, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we do thank you for the opportunity to come up here and testify about your love and what you've done for us, dear Lord. Knowing one day that your return, we'll be living with you eternally, and there'll be no more sickness, no more pain, dear Lord. And we thank you for this church and the love it shows and the encouragement it shows and the man of God that preached the truth, preached the cross, and preached the empty tomb, dear Lord. And we thank you for all that you do for us, and we ask you to bless this offering that we may use it to praise and glorify your name. For it's in the name of Jesus I pray.
choir comes down. Shake hands with someone around you for the first and last word of Green Indiana.
Choices turn. Thank you, Brother Grady. Book of Judges, chapter number 7. Judges, chapter number 7 this morning. Judges 7, the Bible says, "Then Jerubbaal, who was Gideon, and all the people that were with him rose up early, and they pitched beside the well of Pharaoh, so that the host of the Midianites were on the north side of them, by the hill of Moor, in the valley. And the Lord said to Gideon, 'The people that are with thee are too many for me to give the Midianites into their hands. Lest Israel vaunt themselves against me, saying, Mine own hand hath saved me. Now therefore go and proclaim in the ears of the people, saying, Whosoever is fearful and afraid, let him return and depart early from Mount Gilead. And there returned to the people 22,000, and there remained 10,000. And the Lord said to Gideon, The people are yet too many. Bring them down to the water, and I will try them, and I will try them for thee there. It shall be that of whom I say unto thee, this shall go with thee, the same shall go with thee, and of whomsoever I say unto thee, this shall not go with thee, the same shall not go. So he brought down the people into the water, and the Lord said to Gideon, Everyone that lappeth of the water with his tongue, as a dog lappeth, him shalt thou set by himself. And likewise, everyone that boweth down upon his knees to drink. And the number of them that lapped put in their hand and their mouth were 300 men. But all the rest of the people bowed down upon their knees to drink water. Lord, I desire your help this morning. Lord, my prayer is that you give me Holy Ghost boldness. Lord, unction, Lord, to preach, thus saith the Word of God. Help me to preach everything in love. But Lord, I feel like we're living in troublesome times. Hard times, dark times. So Lord, I pray, Father, that you give us the unction and the function to speak to people on the inside as I do my best to preach to them on the outside. Lord, my desire, my plea is that you have me say everything you want me to say. Lord, there might be things I want to say that you don't want me to say. Lord, I pray, God, that you write on my mouth. Lord, shut my mouth if you don't want me to say anything. I want to be pleasing in your sight. I'm not here to please man. I'm here to please you. Lord, I'm just the mailman trying to deliver your message. Lord, I pray that you'd speak to people. Lord, do a work in this place. Help us all to live here knowing what to do in these last days. And we'll praise you, Father, for what you do. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. I've had this thought that the Lord's given me on my heart for about 2.5-3 weeks. And I've just been praying over it and studying over the thought that God's laid on my heart. And ever since Friday's decision by the Supreme Court, I couldn't get away from this. I know that we've got a Supreme Court, but I'm glad that above that we've got a Supreme King. I know they can make their laws and their rules, but it's already recorded in heaven. Amen. Heaven and earth will pass away, but the Lord said His word will never pass away. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. Somebody had said, don't be surprised if Preacher Nathan preaches on sin come Sunday morning. And somebody said, don't be surprised if you don't. Now, I'm going to be honest with you. I've even had a few folks say, Preacher, it surprised me that you've not put anything on Facebook dealing with what's going on. You know, I'll be honest with you, I could get on Facebook and I could put 100 different posts and it's not going to do any good. It's not going to solve anything. We're in a valley right now. And it's not going to be won by not going to be won by tearing down. Now, don't misunderstand me. If it's here Wednesday, you know my stand. I'm against homosexuals. I love them, but I hate to see them. I'm not for homosexual marriage. I have never been, I am not, and I never will be. If a gay couple comes up to me tomorrow and says, you marry us or you go to jail, well, you can just come visit me next door. I'll go to jail. I'd rather go to jail than sell out and go to hell. Now, do I want to go to jail? No. Am I afraid of going to jail? Yeah. Is it coming that way? Probably. But will I? You better believe it. I'm not for the homosexual agenda. I don't support it. I don't support the Supreme Court. I'm not for what our government's doing. Because we're living in a day where day by day by day our freedoms are being stripped from us. So, preacher, who do we turn to? The Lord. Where do we go? Jesus. Jesus is right for whatever's wrong in our life. He is the answer. He was, He is, and He always will be the answer. So, preacher, we're in a war. Let me go ahead and clarify something. I know who's won the war.
Church. I'm telling you, they might take the American flag down. They might take
soapbox this morning. Yeah, I could have come in and just preached. I could have come in and just plowed. But I said, Lord, even though I want to address the sin that's going on, and even though the people of our church know right from wrong you should, amen, I said, Lord, give me something that will still offer growth for the children of God. See, we've lost our burden. I came in here last night. I worked on the bulletin and I came in here for a time of prayer. And I looked around, Sister Carol, all the patriarchs. And listen, I heard somebody say, boy, it's still hard to want to be an American. It's still hard to want to sing these patriotic songs and fly the flag. But you know what? Their lives don't parallel with their posts. People post all this stuff. I'm a Christian. I stand for God and this, that, and the other. But the next day, you don't see them living for the Lord. That's why we're in the shape that we're in. It's because we've had too many anemic Christians like I put in the bulletin. I didn't expect this to shout out today. Does it not trouble anybody that they have took the American flag? I don't want to miss it. But they took the American flag. Now, I'm just going to tell you. I love this flag. There's men and women that have bled and died for this flag. We've got a hero, a true hero, in our church by the name of F.D. Elliott, who has got two purple hearts and fought for this flag. And what they've done is, I seen a picture like, by the way, who'd have ever thought we'd have seen the White House look like a rainbow? Getting quiet. Well, an American flag, I seen last night, they had pictures of the American flag and rainbow colored stripes, rainbow colored stars. And then they took the picture of Iwo Jima. How many knows that? That famous picture where four men, real men, soldiers, were up on that top of Iwo Jima, placing that flag. But instead they took four homosexuals and they got a picture of those four gay men, those four sodomites, standing up there putting in a gay rainbow flag. Somebody needs to do something about it. Yeah. Well, who can fix this? Who has it? Hey, God, I And that is the date, A.D. and B.C. They can take his name off everything, but you can't change what Jesus did 2,000 years ago. But our time, we scale, our calendar is red by what Jesus did for us. What are they going to do? Say, well, we're going to remove. We're going to remove God. We're going to remove any God of the truth. We're just going to stop having days. We ain't going to have no Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Hey, take the days of the week out. God just put this on my heart, brother. John 6. Verse 6. You remember when Jesus had just fed 5,000? And the people are hungry and they want more? Show us another miracle, Lord. And the Lord told him something, Brother Josh. He said, your fathers ate bread in the wilderness and they died. He said, Tori, I'm the true bread that's come down from heaven. He said, I'm the bread. The people said, this is a hard subject. You know what I'm preaching right now and what a lot of preachers are preaching today? It's a hard subject. Brother Fred, a lot of people don't want to hear it. Yeah, I could go up this morning and say, well, I'm afraid of making people mad. I'm afraid to preach. Listen, I'm afraid not to preach Jesus.
Six is the number of man. Seven stripes in the Hebrew rainbow. Amen. Seven is the number of God. Number of perfection. Number of completeness. John 6:66. The Bible says, from that time many walk with him no more. Don't be preachers preach messages today, and guess what? It'll make people, Brother Floyd, so mad that they'll say, I won't go back to that church no more. No more. Listen, I'm telling you, will you also go away? Jesus said, will you go away? They said, who else can we go? Hey, you can't go to the government. You can't go to the Supreme Court. You can't run to your neighbor. As Brother Greg already said, the only hope we've got, the only help we've got is Jesus. Amen. Instead of running to him, we're running from him. Instead of running to him and for him, we're running against him. Am I right about it? Boy, yeah, these are hard messages to preach. I'd like to come in here and preach on heaven. Preacher, you ain't telling us nothing we don't already know. But look at the shape we're in. See, a lot of people don't even realize all. You don't even know the things that me and Brother Jack and other preachers. For instance, if the church does not completely stand with everything that is within the Constitution, the church loses its tax exempt. If they put in the Constitution of the United States that a man and a man and a woman have a right to marry, and they pass that, and we don't stand with that, what happens to the church? See, we don't think about all these things. What happens when the preachers get locked up? When I know this, and we ain't some. Hey, George Patton, I know that name sounds familiar. George Patton, a missionary friend of mine from Haiti. He is in North Carolina right now recovering from some sicknesses. Brother Jack, last night, he sent me pictures of in, I can't even think of the name of it, but Belial, something like that. They, one preacher, they had him nailed to the cross, and Sister Nay, they set him on fire this past week. Three other preachers, they got him burning in a pit on fire. Yeah, I know we ain't stuck in persecution like that, but it's a coming. And it ain't just coming towards the church and towards the preacher. Hey, when the world finds out you're a Christian, it'll come against you. What do we do? When the 20,000 ran too many, when the 10,000, see, they got down on their knees and stayed at the water. But you know the lamp up? While these, I believe those 300, Brother Gray, as they was walking, as they was going into battle, was getting the water. See, these were men that were humble. These were men that had a heart. These were men that made haste. I was reading in Genesis chapter number 19. And you remember after, and oh, by the way, a lot of people said, well, the reason that God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah is because they were gay. Read your Bible. The reason that God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, not just because there was gays. He said he couldn't find even 10 righteous people. That's the word of God. And the Bible says in Ezekiel 22:30 that God saw for a man to make up the hedge to stand in the gap. But Brother Mick, what breaks my heart, the Bible says God found none. He's still looking for some men and women. But you know what? Is he finding any? Is he finding any? Sister April, your daddy said something last weekend at the wedding reception. He got around three or four people, and he was just encouraging me and bragging on me. And I love you, Daddy. He said, right here is a man you won't find nothing on. He's the real deal. That bothered me. I mean, I'm not mad at it. I understood what he said. I praise the Lord that Brother Dean Dyke feels that way about me. Said, you won't find nothing. Now, don't start thinking, well, what's in his closet? What's he been hiding? No, listen. I walked away. If I'm going to be real, I'm going to be real. I hope everybody in this church thinks the world of me. And I think the world of you. But you know what? I don't want you all to think I'm one way and live at home another. And God doesn't want us coming to church and going to work and getting around our family and proclaiming to be one thing when God knows we something else. Yeah. That whole outline I planned for just 2 weeks, I ain't even touched it. Genesis 19. Sister Lisa, the angels come down. They tell Lot, make haste. And I read something, Sister Carol, about Lot that's really gripped my heart. Brother Aaron, the Bible said when the angels said, make haste and get out of the city, Brother Jimmy, you know what the Bible says? It says, Lot lingered. Brother Jack, that spoke to me. Make haste! Get out of the city! Destruction's coming! And Lot lingered. Listen, how many times have we preached? How many times have we sat under a teacher that told you to get right, get ready, get saved? Jesus is coming! Make haste! But we got too many lingering! Too many lingering! Lot's wife didn't want to let go of what she is leaving and turn into a pillar of salt. We got too many. And they lingered. Sister Chris, don't give me a story. God spoke to my heart. If I'm mistaken without crying. A good preacher friend of mine, Gary Quinn, was promoted to glory on Friday. He's fought cancer for 2 years. Man, Don, you know Brother Gary is a tough fighter.
I called his wife, Preacher Tom, on Friday, heartbroken. I said, sis, I wish I could come be with you and your family right now. I said, that's so hard of a drive to get there. And I said, depending on maybe when the funeral is next week, I can make it up. She said, Preacher, I just want to testify something. She said, do you know Samantha Gary's sister? I said, I do not. She said, well, you know, he's fought, he's preached, he's battled cancer for 2 years. Said, over the last 2 months, he's preached sitting down on his walker. I said, yes. She said, this past week, Samantha came in with a tape. Brother Gary's old-fashioned, I mean, he didn't have a CD or whatever. And she brought in a tape. And on that tape, on one side, she put all these different scriptures had about healing, about claiming healing and God's promises of this, that, and that. And she said, Brother Gary, she said to her brother, she said, Gary, she said, as long as you're still willing to fight and keep on keeping on, and won't the big cancer say it, I want you to listen to this side of the tape that has all these scriptures on healing. She said, but when you're tired of fighting, when you just want to go on, she said, turn the tape over. And on that side of the tape, she had every verse she could find about healing. And Friday, he told Jackie, his wife, he said, baby, turn the tape over. Within an hour, he made his cross. When I look at the Lord, Sister Billy and all that's going on, Brother Ross, you know what I'm ready to do? Just hit eject and turn the tape over. I know we're living in dark times. And listen, I prayed over this thing. I didn't sleep hardly a wink last night. I prayed over this thing, Brother Dan. I thought, how can I make this encouraging? There ain't nothing encouraging about what's going on in the world. There ain't a thing good about it. But I tell you what, I'm just looking up because my redemption groweth nigh. I want to be like John and say, even so come, Lord Jesus. Yeah. I don't want to linger around. Amen. I told Uncle Mike in the choir, I said, let's get right for the flight. Praise the Lord. There was too many. See, Sister Brenda, they say, we're the minority now. We're too small of a group. Well, the Lord said, I can't do it with that many. Maybe I can do it with this small group. I can't answer for nobody else but me. I can't answer for my little sweethearts. I can't answer for our church family. You can't answer for nobody but for yourself. But I'm waiting for Jesus to come back. And until he comes back, I'm going to keep marching. Amen. I'm going to keep that humble heart. I'm going to make haste. I'm going to be hearty. I'm going to be healthy. I'm going to keep on keeping on with the Master. There's too many who ain't. Jesus is looking for, hey, I think I put it in the bulletin. It's been on my mind. The army's looking for a few good men. The Lord's just looking for a few good Christians. Amen. With every head bowed and every eye closed. Like I said, this battle is going to be won by being on our face before God and praying. I encourage you just to come pray this morning. If you need to be saved, I invite you to come. Tell us you need to be saved. If you need to get things right, I encourage you to come. If you just want to pray, pray for churches. If you ain't got nothing to pray, would you pray for the preacher? Because I don't know, Brother Jack, what we're going to face. Pray for America. Pray for us. Pray for our churches. Amen. Hey, I thought, if you want to pray for us, just pray Jesus come back and get us. Amen. I'm ready. Lord, we love you. I pray, Father, that you take this message. Help us, Lord. Lord, the Lord, you told us in your word there's too many with the great things that you did with 300. Lord, we might be one little church, we might be one little nucleus, but God, you still did great things in our lives through us and for us.
And Lord, if we know somebody who does not agree with your word and with you, Lord, we're not to hate them. We're not to be mean to them. But Lord, help us to stand up to them and tell them that we love them and that Jesus loves them and they need to get born again. Lord, I don't want anybody to go to hell. I want everybody to be saved. But Lord, they got to turn from their wicked lifestyle. Not just homosexual. Lord, it could be any. It could just be sin. There's a lot of things that fall under sin. Help us all be right before Jesus comes. We'll praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's stand 483.
You need to come to God. That's not to help you.
Bye.
sin not. I pray they give us a righteous anger. We ought to get angry over all this stuff that's going on. Amen. We just ain't got no freedoms. Amen. Maybe in this world. But this world, hey, Brother Larry, someone said it's hard to be a citizen of America. Listen, I'm just living here for, the Bible says, let my conversation be in heaven. I'm a citizen of the glory world. Amen. Amen. Heaven's my home. I'm just passing through. Praise the Lord. Amen. You've been good listeners today. The ladies singing today, 5:15. I still love America. And the red, white, and blue, our church looks pretty this morning. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Brother Floyd, would you pray for us?
Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege that you've given us to be back in your house again this morning. Father, we thank you that you've sent us a man of God to preach the word of God. Father, we love you. We appreciate you. And as much as we love our pastor, we love you and your son, Lord. And we thank you that you have sent your son to this earth to die for our sins. And Father, we look forward when your son comes back and gets us and takes us home. Until that time, Father, help us to be strong in our faith. Pray, upholding your name and waiting for your return. Rich in your son's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.